see that it's scheduling and then matrix report. There are two things.
Yes.
Yeah. So today we are going to work on these two areas, and then from next week, from tomorrow, we are working on the calculated fields.
Awesome.
And then we will work on the performance report performance.
Awesome.
Calculated field, I assume that it will take a couple of days, and the performance will take like the same day, like a couple of like 30 minutes or maybe more, less than that.
I was wondering, can we return back to our other reports afterwards as well, so that we have a more solid understanding, or I have a more understanding of it? And also, I was asked if it's possible. I'm not too sure, but if it's possible, can we look into a bit into the finance reporting as well to see the difference between the two?
Okay, so first of all, like, will we go back to the original reports? I think I'll let you give a time in a day for like try to practice it, and then if you have a question, I can get back to you, or you can ask me the question for in one of the session, and we can work on that. And the financial report, yes, when we are going to discuss about like the objects, we are going to discuss those things too in more detail.
Oh,
like,
cool.
What are the differences? It's the objects, but again, I would like to write. Generally, we have done a lot of reports, right? Not a lot, but we done reports. So what I was expecting, that you can work on it, like you take your time and you can try to read the things, and you can come up with some of the questions, and I would be more easily answer your questions.
Awesome. I'm quite excited to hear.
The most important thing is you need to work, start working on it, right?
Right.
To do practice, and then you come up with the questions.
Okay. Sounds good.
Okay. So let's say we create a simple report, like the advanced report. Okay, now I have a report with the legal first name and last name, these two columns, and it's not shared with anyone, right?
Correct.
It will bring some data, but it would not be shared with anyone. Like, no one is going to receive it. No one is going to see that. For example, if I'll go on, like, let's say, Bob Stalk or anyone, it would not be available for them, right?
Correct.
So, because like I didn't share with this, you remember that security portion we discussed yesterday, right?
Uh-huh.
This report was not shared within anyone.
Yes.
So if I go here on these three dots, and you know that normally we do run, right?
Yes.
So if we don't do run and we are trying to schedule it, and if I run now, like the frequencies run now, or there are more than one frequencies, run now, run in future, run in daily recurrence, weekly, monthly, and everything.
Yes.
Yeah. So if I just run it now and click OK, then it will come up with this screen. It will not run. It will ask me, like, either I wanted to do the output in Excel, PDF, or CSV.
Uh-huh.
And then to whom I would like to share this report output. any security group, any authorized user, like any person. Like, for example, I'm just saying that I just copy the name Bob's Stalk, and I wanted this report to be sent to him. And I agree to the statement. What is statement? Statement is this. Specifically, sharing option for the report. Note that the share report output with the users below, you are authorized the specific users the right to view the report and its data exactly as you see it. Regardless of their security, like even if the people do not have access or not, you will get this information to them, right? This is by default. Like either they have access or not. This is bypass their security. You are just telling them they don't have a security access, but still do that.
Correct. I see.
Okay, if I click OK, then it will automatically run now and it will go to the shared output like this. And the same, like Bob will also receive this output. See, the Bob will also. Did it make sense?
Yes, it makes sense.
Yeah. Okay, so this is how you can share the report. You can also run this report like by scheduling it, and you can schedule it for a lot of things. Like you can do the daily reoccurrence. That means that you want this report to run for someone for daily, and you can give the time, and you can run it now, and the start date, end date, and then you share the output like in Excel or something, and then you will share the output automatically. Make sense?
Yes, it makes sense.
Okay, so this is very simple that you can share your report output result even if people do not have access to them, and you can send it their inbox, like it's sending it to their inbox. Okay, so this is more or less when you are working in your company, you will need it. Okay, so this is like the normally in your company you will get these accesses, and you need to share this type of information with some of the people, even they don't have access, but they want this.
Oh, okay. Go share.
Yeah, and especially this happens in your life like several times. Okay,
Okay.
let me open this report again, and now I'll go here and I'll sh go to the advanced and see, sorry, our shared. I can see that the report output is with John's, right?
Correct, correct.
So I would try to transfer this ownership to someone else. So what I can do, there is a transfer ownership task, and you can transfer the ownership to the new owner, whoever you want to. Make sense?
Yes.
And if you go on these three dots, you can also delete the report. Right? These are the important functions we have discussed.
Is everything okay?
Yep.
Oh, okay. I see.
Okay, so scheduling our report is normally it happens like, for example, if you have a payroll in your company and you don't want or they do not have a relevant access, you can send this output to the payroll team. And they can read it automatically every weekend because it's a scheduling of the things, and then the transfer ownership is like when a person is terminated or this report is assigned to someone else, you can transfer it to yourself. So here technically we have closed our advanced reporting session, and now we are working on the metrics report. Did you remember that you mentioned that if we start with the temporary report, can we make it permanent? Did you remember that question?
Yeah, that was from yesterday.
Yeah. So if you have advanced and if you have a temporary report, let's say, then this is a temporary report. Look at this.
So how
You
long
can
does
change.
temporary report last? Oh, yep. Oh, I see it.
So you can change it to 2023. And click OK, so it's for next year. And if you decided to keep it forever, you go here on Edit and go to Advanced, and you remove this, and it will be last forever. Make sense?
Yep, I like
Okay.
that. Yeah.
Yeah. So this is possible.
Okay.
Now, we are going to touch base on the metrics report. Metrics report is in the rows and columns, both are changing, right? You know about the metrics report, don't you?
Correct.
So
Yes.
we are going to create a custom report with the metrics report actually.
Okay.
That's a create custom report task, same. Metrics, sorry, it's a metrics. Report type should be metrics and all active employee.
Okay. Oh, there's a misspell. Yep. All active employees. It possible to do a data sort for all active? Yeah, never mind. It makes, yeah, okay.
So what I wanted to do, I wanted to see the comp like the company, any companies I have in the system,
Okay.
and then I wanted to know the gender, like how many males and females, and I just go okay with this and run it. So now see, I have a three companies. Alma Master University Foundation, Metro University Canada, and Metro University USA. And there is a person with the blank company. And there are gender is a Verna Report 2, Verna Report 2, Verna Report 2. This is wrong. We choose the wrong function. Someone is trying to create it for the test purpose, and we pick the wrong function about that. I can go here and I can see that this is like a object and this is uncategorized. So someone has created it. So I will just try to write the gender again. And this is the right field because this is a Workday delivered field.
Wait,
Thank
can
you.
you do that again?
I'll do that. I'll give me 1 second. I'll run it and I'll show you again.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
It's okay. Now, if you look at the Alma University USA, you can see that there is a male and female. Metro University Canada, there is a female and male. And USA, not declared to. And we have a different type of people in the different companies with the different genders. Make sense? Now, I
Yes.
don't like it. Like, I wanted this gender to come here. Like, gender one, gender two, or something like that, right? So I go and edit it. And I remove this gender from here and I put the gender group in the group by field.
Sorry?
So when I run this, now you see that there is a less thing and there is some more columns here. In the USA, Alma University, there is a male 145 and female 123, and there are blank two and not declared three. And if I click on these numbers, it will open these three names.
Okay, cool.
And if I click on this, it will bring all the 273 employees. And I can see that, let's say it's two and the blank, I'll open it. And I'll open the employee in the next window. And I go into the personal, and I see that the gender is not entered. So that makes sense. But I want this thing in more detail, right? When I click on these two, there will be not only the employee we need. I need something more. Like my manager says that let's bring some more information for them. I go and edit this.
Okay.
I go to the drill down and I click on the details. I'll click on the employee ID.
Employee ID, I see.
I click on the employee.
I'm
I
sorry.
click on, yeah.
When you're doing this, where would it be if you just click, if you, so what if I didn't know where would the employee ID be under the, would it be by
Click on the
category?
all.
Okay.
Sorry, all will not work because there are a lot of people, but categorized. And you can find the from the which category you want to pick.
I
So
see.
probably I'm looking for the worker information, right? So I'll
Correct.
click on the worker here.
Okay. Because
And then I bring. But generally I'll tell you that how did I normally read to this level. This is on my agenda, like how to find out like the fields and all these details.
by company? Okay.
Yeah, I'm just adding company, right? And I click OK now. And I run it. And if I click on these three,
Okay.
see the employee ID, employee, and the company. Everything is there.
I see. Understood. I've
Okay,
tried
then I
to.
go and edit. I can go and edit again, right? And then I wanted one more thing. I don't want the output in table. I wanted it in the chart and table both, and click OK. And I run it. So now you see that. Did you see that the graphical representation? Makes sense. Like these are all females, this is males, this is females, this is blank, this is not declared. And when I click here, I can see the not declared here too. Makes sense. So you can change, you go and edit there, and if you don't like this graph, you can change the graph too. And let's say I remove gender from here, and I just wanted to put gender here. And I'll go to the output and the graphs option, chart options are here. And this is like a cluster, so I wanted to change it to, let's say, bubble. A bubble doesn't work with this
Oh.
line. See,
Cool.
it, of course, this does not make any sense because like the graph is not correct, which I
Right.
used, but I can use like the different options.
Understood.
And I
Understood.
can configure it on the runtime here too. Makes sense, right?
Yes.
And this is more pretty, like a Donut's graph is more better to see that, like. So you can create a n number of matrix report. You should have some requirements, how to create it, like sorry, what to create it. Like the more absolute criteria you have, the more easily you will decide like which report you are going to use and what will be the benefit out of it.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Any question, anything? Do you want me to discuss any point of view here or not? I remember your one question, which I'm going to discuss now, but before that.
Okay, so I'm trying to recreate what you have by memory. So from the data source, where are you getting the information from?
Okay, so this is a data source. If I click and open it in another window, I will see all the fields available for this person. Right? Or if I'll go and open this person, I know that this is a gender, this is a date of birth, this is a marital status, this is documentation, and a lot of things here. I can read their names from here, like a personal information. I can read the gender. I can read the go to the overview and for find like the compensation, and I'll find like the total base pay, salaries, and all this stuff. That's why, if you
Right.
remember that I asked you yesterday that did you work on the like did you have the LMS training or not, and you mentioned not so.
Yeah. Okay. It, no. So my question was, so in the data source, I don't have the option to choose all active employees.